Hello, welcome. You're watching Headset VR. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to a brand new gaming video. Today, we're going to be playing the part of a radio DJ from the 80s. This is a murder mystery come puzzle slash horror slash horror slash horror slash. It's a slasher horror. Anyway, this is Killer Frequency. So I'm just going to dive right in. And let's get into this 80s murder mystery that is Killer Frequency. Okay, so standard movement. So it looks like we've got some variation of snap turn, which is a little bit poor, to say the least. Picking up objects. Cool. That's creepy. I'm just gonna go with the flow, really. Can I press that button? No. Oh, okay, so the stick is artificial crouch, artificial stand. Yep, that's great. And, oh, do you mind? You piece of shit. Fuck's sake!
You hear something, Peggy?
Huh? Hear what?
I thought I heard someone yelling, or... I don't know, a... howl?
Forrest, is this a joke?
No, I... almost swore I heard something.
Oh, and here I was thinking you'd finally started to ease up. You probably just heard some cats outside.
Cats?
You know, four legs, whiskers, tails, not dogs.
I know what a cat is.
This is your brain, Forrest. Sorry I made you such an unfun turkey.
Now, let's get the show started. Okay, you're live in 3,
oh, shit.
2...
189.16.
And you're listening to 189.16, The Scream.
Right, so while we've got a little bit of a pause there, I'm just going to say, as I'm sure I've mentioned some anyway, but I've been that distracted, you're watching Headset VR playing the brand new release of Killer Frequency, which came out yesterday on Steam, but it also came out with support from VR on the Quest. Now, I would rather have probably waited to see if it came out as a Rift title as well on Steam, or also on PSVR 2. But I was that keen to play it, I just bought it. So this is now available on the Quest store for about £21. Now, the premise is you're a DJ, as you can see. I've always wanted to be a DJ. In fact, I did actually used to be one years ago. But yet you're a DJ, and there's a serial killer that comes back from the 50s, starts killing people off. They'll call him, and I've got to help solve puzzles to help them escape the killer. So, without any further ado, I'm just going to dive straight in and carry on from where we've gone.
Time to go on the journey that is Blast Processor with their hit song, 1980X.
Oh, God, Forrest, that was amazing! Forrest, there's a call coming in.
Oh, here we go.
Welcome to 189.16, The Scream, caller. You're talking to Forrest Nash. What's going on with you tonight?
Forrest, thank God I made it through. My name is Leslie Harper. I'm the 911 operator and police dispatcher for Gallows Creek.
Welcome to the show, Leslie. Are you calling in to guess that scream? As a 911 operator, I bet you may have an educated guess.
What? No! Look, I found a body and I need your help.
911 is calling me to report a body. Interesting setup. All right, I'll bite. What's the punchline then?
Forrest, I recognize your voice. I'm pretty sure that actually is our 911 operator. I think this is real.
Peggy, I'm not gonna be happy if this is a prank. I don't do prank segments on my shows. It's in my contract.
Forrest, I really don't think this is a prank.
Leslie, I'll level with you. I find this hard to believe, but I'll hear you out. What exactly is going on?
Sheriff Matthews is dead.
What? Sheriff Matthews is dead?
I couldn't get any response from the department. That's never happened before, so I came to the station and I found him.
Oh, God, poor Sheriff Matthews. Do you know what happened to him?
Someone got him. Someone got up very close and I really don't want to say what they did to him.
Did he fight back?
I don't know. I think he tried. He's surrounded by bullet casings. I think he tried to shoot at whoever it was, but...
I don't understand. Where are the other officers? Do they know? Have they secured the scene or whatever cops are supposed to do?
No. I checked everywhere. Deputy Martinez is here, but she's knocked out, tied up, and locked in a holding cell. I called you right after I found her.
God. Wait. Please don't tell me that this hick town only has two cops.
Don't be ridiculous. We have three. But Officer Gunderson is on leave in Cancun.
Leslie, Do you have any idea who could have done this?
Not a clue. I didn't see anything on my way over.
Leslie, you need to call over to Henderson or Quiet Ridge. They need to send someone over from their department.
I tried, but I can't call anything but local numbers. Something's wrong. I'll have to go there myself. Let them know what's going on and bring help back with me.
But if you leave while there's a murderer on the loose, who's gonna man the emergency line?
That's why I called. Forrest, I've routed all 911 calls to come in to you.
You can count on me. I'll do what I can.
I have an emergency. I need to get an unconscious Deputy Martinez out of that holding cell. It looks like whoever attacked her threw the keys into the cell after they locked the door.
There's got to be another set of keys somewhere in that office. Those can't be the only one. Maybe Sheriff Matthews had a set of keys on him when he, you know.
I couldn't see any at a glance, but I didn't really look up close. One second. Oh, I think I might be sick. Sorry, Sheriff. I'm just gonna turn you over and... Please don't stare at me. That might be them. I think I got the cell keys.
Looks like Sheriff Matthews might have saved his deputy. Do the keys work?
They do. Give me a minute to untie Deputy Martinez. I'm taking her in the car with me to get help in Henderson. If the killer came back now, Martinez would be a sitting duck.
That's a good idea. We don't want to take any risk right now.
Thank you, Forrest. You and Peggy just work together like you did earlier. You can do this. Now I'll be back as soon as I... What? My car! My car is on fire!
What do you mean it's on fire?
How the hell? Did it just go up in smoke? What happened?
Wait. What? No. No way. This can't... Well, Forrest, we have big trouble.
What's happening? What's that noise? It sounds like whistling?
Whistling? It can't be.
Oh, my God. I can see him, but he's dead, right? Right? But that mask... How the hell is he?
Who, Leslie? Who?
The
Whistling Man? Who's the Whistling Man?
He was a serial killer back in the 50s. Wore that mask. But he's dead! He's... What the hell?
Oh, God. Do you think he attacked Sheriff Matthews and Deputy Martinez?
He's coming this way!
Stay inside and lock the doors!
Right.
Forrest, come on! You need to focus!
This is getting creepy.
New plan. My car's torched! We need to think!
Man,
there should be police cruisers at the sheriff's office, right? Like, you should take one of those.
Yeah, that could work. Let me check if Martinez has any... just reach into your pocket there, deputy, and... Yes, got it. Keys for squad car 3. I saw that parked out front when I got here.
Nice one, Forrest. Good thinking.
But wait. How am I supposed to get us to the car? The whistling man is right there.
The sheriff must have a gun, right? Can you see it?
There was a gun next to him. Let me grab it. Shit. It's empty.
He must have emptied it trying to defend himself.
Are there any other weapons lying around that you could use?
I didn't see anything earlier. Let me check Deputy Martinez's belt. All right. It looks like the whistling man left her with a baton, pepper spray, and taser. I can only hold one if I'm carrying Deputy Martinez. Which should I take?
I mean, it's gotta be the taser, right?
Got it. I'm just going to grab Deputy Martinez and then... Wait. Do you hear that?
No, I can't hear anything.
Exactly. It's gone quiet. No more knocking.
Be careful. I don't like it.
Me neither. But it's an opening, and I've got to take it. Okay.
It's a trap.
Deputy Martinez, if you can hear me, it's time to move. Just lean on me. Yep. There you go.
Are you sure about this, Leslie?
No time like the present, right? So, here we go. Again, you're hooked into dispatch now, so I should be able to radio you when I reach the car. If I reach it. Speak to you soon.
Well, luck.
Hello? Forrest? Peggy? This is Leslie. Are you there? Over.
We're here, Leslie. So I guess you made it to the car then. Over?
Sorry about the CB chat. Old habit. But yes, we made it to the car. Deputy Martinez is in the passenger seat, still out cold. I don't see the whistling man anywhere, and I don't plan to wait for him. So I'm going to get us moving. Jesus! God damn it! Get back! Get away from her!
Leslie, what's happening?
The whistling! No! Get off her, you son of a bitch! Yeah! Take that!
Leslie, drive!
Don't worry, Deputy Martinez. We're out of here.
Sounds like you handled that pretty well.
Yes!
Forrest, that taser? Definitely the right call. Oh. Oh my god, I can't believe we escaped.
Well done, Leslie. You saved a life. Just another day for you.
Oh my god, yeah. Forrest, Peggy, I've gotta go. I'll be out of range soon. But I'll radio back as soon as I can once I got the cavalry.
Take care, Leslie. Be safe out there.
Good luck, Leslie! Feel better soon, Deputy Martinez!
Uh-oh. Didn't get a chance to say goodbye. Well, look, okay, this has really got interesting quick, hasn't it?
For now. Here's another hit record for you all to enjoy. Now it's time to go with The Flow, and this is their hit, Crying for Help. Hello, caller. You're live on 189.16, The Scream. Is everything, all right? Okay, who is this? Are you, hello? Hello?
It's him. Help!
Okay, what's your name and why are you calling in?
You know
This next one's dedicated to all of you staying inside with your doors and windows locked.
It's funky, it's groovy, it's Stabbing the Twilight by Knife and Easy.
We already have another caller on the line.
All right.
Okay.
Let's do this.
Well, just before that, I'd like to point out that I think this game so far is absolutely great. I'm already feeling myself getting hooked into it. It's a bit of a murder mystery, and it's quite creepy as well.
We have a call waiting.
Yep, I know. I just wanted to say a few things. It's great that you can be a DJ. I mean, it's the Meta Quest. The graphics aren't, you know, next generation PSVR2 kind of thing. It's all about the story, though. So, let's see what the next caller is. And so far, I'm giving a big thumbs up to this game. Apart from a couple of minor quibbles.
I suppose I should take this call.
Which don't really make too much of an impact on the game. Well, any impact on the game. Other than that, I'm giving this a 9 out of 10 so far. I'd say play it.
Time to turn the music off.
Oh, dancing! Oh, can I give her a finger? Oh. No, I didn't mean finger all that. I meant as in... Oh, never mind, no. Dig myself a bigger hole.
Hello, caller. You're live on The Scream with me, Forrest Nash.
Forrest Gump. Okay, Nash.
What? I need the sheriff right away.
I'm sorry, Sandra, but the sheriff is dead.
What? God. Listen, you've got to help me then. I drove to the edge of town for a jazz run, and now some psycho dressed like the Whistling Man is after me, knife in hand.
Oh, God. It's actually happening.
Where are you now? Did you escape to somewhere safe?
Oh, I did, baby. I jazz ran all the way to my car and nothing flat. But I dropped my keys somewhere along the way. I never locked the door. I've got a place to hide, but I can't get moving.
Can you go back and find your keys?
Well, I'm not going back out there.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shoot. Oh, he's back. Look, I don't know a thing about cars. But I gotta start this engine without the keys. And you're gonna have to help me.
This game's creepy so far. I'm pretty well impressed with what Team 17 have done. I mean, okay, so the graphics ain't exactly like, say, next generation. But you know what? I don't think that really matters, does it? When you've got a story like this, does it really make a difference? No, it doesn't. Because this is a highly chilling plot. I'm honestly getting goosebumps playing this. Sitting here now, I can just feel the hair stand up on the back of my neck. There's a killer out there and I need to help people. I really feel absorbed in this.
Did you find anything?
Yeah, I found a magazine about hot wiring cars.
Well, that sounds perfect. Okay, Forrest, shut the music off. Caller on line one.
Thanks, Peggy. We're back with 189.16, The Scream. How are you holding up, Sandra?
The creep's looking through the parking lot trying to find me. But I've got my tools, and I'm ready to get this hunk of junk moving. How do we start this baby?
Unscrew the steering column.
All right. Just turn. 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, God. How long are these screws? Okay. Off. Okay. There's a bunch of wires down here all paired up and oh God, my heart is pumping. Okay, I can do this. There's a red wire, a blue wire, a yellow wire, a green wire, and a brown wire. Fantastic work, baby. Anytime you want to come down to the jazz studio, you get in for free.
Take it what? Away, Forrest.
Enjoy this classic by Smooth. It's their hit song, The Word.
Yeah, all right. Chill out, woman.
Evening, caller. This is Forrest Nash, host of 189.16, The Scream. And tonight's 911 stand-in.
Yeah, Leslie. This is Maurice Russell from the Gallows Reporter. I'm at the office. This guy just broke in downstairs and Forrest Nash? I want to speak to 911. Put Leslie on.
What? God, another one?
I'm guessing you've not been tuned in to our show tonight.
Damn it, son. What does that have to do with anything? Just put me on with Sheriff Matthews.
Sheriff Matthews is dead.
Dead? What happened? Did you witness the incident? Are you willing to do an interview for the reporter? I can cite you as an anonymous source, if that's a concern.
We're live on the air. Anything we say can and will be broadcast.
Live on? Damn it. All right. There's obviously a lot more going on than I know.
Yeah, there's a lot happening tonight. You said someone broke in.
That's nothing to get worked up about. Some idiot kid just broke in.
Where are you now?
I'm in the boardroom, upstairs. We got security cameras all around the building. Watch them on any TV set here. And there's a set in the boardroom.
Maurice, is there any way you can get out of there?
I sure as shit hope so, kid. But I'm not sure how I'm going to do it. That crash you heard was him tipping over my filing cabinets. He's blocking the stairs.
I'm guessing the stairs are the only way out?
That's right.
Okay, folks, we're back on the line with Maurice. Let's see if we can help him avoid the Whistling Man.
Here's the situation. The Whistling Man searched every room in the hall leading up to the boardroom. And now he's in the office next door. It's now or never. I've got it all figured out. The secret archive. There's no lock on the inside of that room, only the outside. You can't break out. If we can get him in there, and I lock him in...
We can catch the son of a gun.
Exactly. I found the radio.
Oh, there you go.
It's right where I thought it would be.
It's all coming together.
I'm just going to turn it on quickly, make sure it's still got some juice.
Maurice, turn the volume down. We don't want that thing blasting just yet.
Yeah, I knew that, Nash. I was just doing that when you yelled at me. The radio works! If I make it out alive, Hopkins might just get that day off he wanted. He's earned it.
Let's do it for Hopkins, Forrest.
Wait. Aw, goddammit. If I can't have this stupid thing turned up, how am I supposed to draw the killer? I can't be in the room when it's up.
This is tense.
I'll call you guys from my office in a second.
Ooh, call coming in. Here we go.
I'm here. The radio's set up in the secret archive. Just give me the signal, and I'll turn it all the way up, all right? Well, this is it. I'm going to go turn the radio up to full blast now. Don't say anything until I've had time to hide. You got it?
We know the plan. You can trust us.
Here we go.
Oh, shit.
Forrest Dash, you son of a bitch! I told you to...
Forrest, he's...
out of print. We'll be back soon.
Okay, so you've been watching Headset VR, playing Killer Frequency on the Quest 2 headset. If you've liked what you've seen so far, please hit the like button. You can subscribe to the channel to see more content of games like this.
I better put a record on.
Yep, also PSVR, Oculus Rift, PC VR, and as I said, MetaQuest as well. So if you can subscribe to the channel, you'll see all those kind of bits of content, also VR mod setup guides, also live streams, and along with VR tomfoolery, which we all love.
Dead air is a crime, Forrest.
It is, yeah. So that's why I'm going to say thank you for watching. If you have any comments to make about this video or any of the other content we put out on the channel, please do so in the comments below. They all get responded to, unless you're a complete douchebag, in which case you'll get a different finger to that one. Anyway, I'm going to sign
off. Come on, Forrest, put some music on already.
All right, I'm going to sign off with this record, and we'll see you for the next one. Take care, folks. Enjoy.
It's David Scopo with Moonlight.
Well, this is going to be a long night.
Oh, really? I feel like it's going pretty quickly to me. Hold on. Someone just rang the door buzzer.
Really? Think someone needs our help?
Maybe. You want to go check it out?
Me? You sure you don't want to go?
No way. I'm locked up tight in here. I'll pass you the key to the stairs.
Okay, down to the first floor, then check the door. A tape. Play on air.
Okay, well, I'm not sure what that was, but this seems like it could be really creepy, and I'm gonna save it for the next video, because I'm absolutely enthralled by this game so far. But I am out of time, and we're gonna leave this here, and we're gonna play this the next time round. So thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.